Motorcycle ride-hailing firm Angkas may get another 6 months to operate under the government's extended pilot run, but will now do so with at least half a dozen other competitors. But with us now for more in the studio is Angkas Chief Transport Advocate George Royeca. Good to have you back on, George. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Kathy. Thanks for having me.
So you had asked for this extension as the 6 month pilot run ends on December 26. Why?
Well, primarily, we were hoping that we'll be able to pass the law within the first 6 months. But even during the TWG discussions, we had a provision there that just in case that there were delays, we hope that there will be no disruption of service. So we hope it was going to be smooth transition between the pilot and when the law was passed. So that's why we're asking for an additional extension so that we have enough time to get the law passed.
So what's causing the delay? Is it from the legislator side or more of the data collection side from your end?
I think there's a lot of different factors, right? First off, I mean, there were a lot of budget hearings in the beginning of, towards the end of the year, so when the Congress and Senate started. So that contributed to a little bit of delays in the committee hearings. But also, we've been working very hard with, the regulators to be able to really come up with a proper framework for regulations, both on the safety monitoring, safety and the monitoring side. So it's just taking a little bit of time on both ends.
In terms of the data, because that's really interesting to the lawmakers and to the public at large, what sort of data have you collected in the past 6 months that would prove operational readiness and compliance from Angkas' side?
I think really it's the safety protocols, right? Especially the safety standard. Are we able to uphold the safety standard even as we scale more passengers and bikers? I'm glad to report to everybody the last TWG that we presented the latest updates. We were able to uphold the 99.997% safety record. But I think to that, we really need to also ensure the proper regulations in place and how to monitor this safely, and also to do conflict resolution for accidents, right? So because of this, we've had built over the last 6 months a medical response team that would enable us to handle these situations. Insurance is also a big issue. All of the public transportation are using consortium insurance just because of the scale. We've had quite a number of issues for a non-consortium insurance provider. So these are the things that are really, we really need to take a look at, because if you're going to do this in a nationwide basis with multiple players, then those are some of the major safety concerns that needs to be addressed.
And that's exactly how it's going to look like over the next 6 months. You're going to have to operate Angkas for the next half year with competition in tow. There are at least half a dozen others wanting in, and among them Joyride, whom I spoke with, saying that they're ready to hit the road, and another five are also egging to enter the pilot run. Among them, City Mover, Move It, Eset Go, Sakai, and Room Go.
Competition is something that we welcome. It's definitely good for consumers. I'm quite relieved in the sense, or comforting to see that there are other players that are willing to push for the regularization and the legitimization of motorcycle taxis. And I hope the entire industry does come together to push this. It's really become an advocacy for us more than just a business. But that being said, we really need to make sure that the entire industry, adheres to the strictest safety protocols that Angkas has set forth.
Talk to us about that industry, George. Just how big is the market for motorcycle ride-hailing firms in the Philippines? Because Joyride's Gino Arvizu told me in the November 28 chat that 80% of the market remains unserved. Here's how he said it.
The unserved market really is big, about 80%. The data shows even with the 27,000 bikers of Angkas, it's not even enough to cater to the demand. Around 80%. So really, in your tagline, it's not even competition.
Not even competition. Do you agree with what Gino said, George?
I think right now, really the focus of the industry is really to develop the proper safety regulation and the safety framework to make sure that we run this on a nationwide scale effectively and safely. Now, on the demand side, we are at the bare months, and when it's nearing December, there's really a spike in demand. But essentially, you're looking at really just the morning and the evening peak that a lot of these transport motorcycle transport services are really servicing. So you need to find a way to make sure that the proper allocation is put in place for different areas of the metro and also outside the of the metro, and make sure that you have enough supply and demand. So it's still the demand is quite high. You still see a lot of informal motorcycle taxis there, or what we call the habal-habals. But you still need to regulate than the amount of units on a per area basis.
So are you going to be bringing more bikers on board over the next 6 months during the extended run?
Well, I don't know. That really is up to the regulators. We're just waiting on basically what the regulators will be giving an order to. Right now, we're just really hoping for the extension. And we definitely welcome new players into the market, and hopefully the entire industry for motorcycle taxis is formed.
But what sense are you getting among the lawmakers on the urgency that they're giving to the issues surrounding the motorcycle ride hailing market? Because several bills have been filed in both the Senate and the House of Representatives seeking to legalize the motorbike taxis, and they're also pending.
Well, I think the commitment is there. I mean, the commitment is very firm and very clear from both houses to be able to push this along. But safety is really a big concern. You have to treat motorcycles, two wheels, very differently from four wheels. Two wheels have an inherent vulnerability. It's exposed to the elements. And it's really a different way of regulating, a different way of monitoring. And there's a different set of rules that needs to be put in place. And I think right now we're in uncharted territory. So it's a little bit of difficult on both ends, and at the end of the day, we all want the same thing, which is the safety of the commuters. That's the primordial concern.
Just very quickly, how's Angeline holding up? I spoke to her on this many months back. I mean, she's the founder of Angkas, all the way from Singapore, relocating here after seeing the great need for quicker commutes because of the traffic.
Well, no rest for the wicked. Even in this holiday season, I mean, we have a big family here in Angkas. We have 27,000 bikers and a few million commuters. So really our focus is to make sure that they're okay, especially during this Christmas time. So no vacations, unfortunately, for us right now.
Okay, so she's in here for the long haul.
Definitely.
All right. Well, thank you so much, George. Appreciate it, and all the best in the next 6 months. George Royeca of Angkas in Makati.
Thank you, Kathy.